Is it possible to graduate college without debt? Let's explain that. Hey everyone, and welcome to Things Explained. If you're in college, you understand why debt can be so intimidating. In this video, I'm going to tell my story of how I graduated college debt-free. The process starts early, so not every situation may be applicable to you. Don't worry, these principles still apply to everyone. And if not able to eliminate student debt, can still help to minimize it. I read an article a while back that explained how millennials can save $10,000 in a year. Step 1, spend $5,000 less in the year. And step 2, get an extra job to make an extra $5,000. My tips won't be like that. I'll even talk about how you can graduate in a good position to get a good job. So to start off, I'll split expenses into two categories, school and living. School expenses are those that are related to school, like tuition, fees, and books. I know you may have your heart set on the Ivy League school, and you just barely got accepted, but consider the costs. When I was deciding on a grad school, I visited a university with a good ranking and one that was slightly higher ranked. The slightly lower one had very small school expenses after everything, while the slightly higher option was tens of thousands more expensive per year. One student told me not to worry about the money because my experience was priceless. If you are made of money, then by all means, go live that kind of life. But I'm assuming that if you're watching this video, your money actually means something to you. Now, in case you're wondering, I chose the cheaper option, and I've had an excellent experience in education so far. Sometimes better schools may cost more, but there are plenty of high-quality schools that won't ask for your firstborn. Another way to reduce school expenses is getting help. Scholarships are the best way to pay for college. For this reason, the process of graduating college debt-free starts in high school. I can't tell you how often I would see people showing up 30 minutes late for class or not doing homework. Well, I was pushing myself every day. I can't help but wonder where they are in life now. If you're in high school, take the time now to start investing in yourself. Don't let yourself be intimidated by thinking you have to be the best or get the very top scholarship. There are lots of options for scholarships if you're willing to look. Many states have public scholarship programs for students attending within the state, and they are very attainable. Now, when I was in high school, I didn't have to have a job or help provide for my family. I recognize that not everyone is as fortunate. If you have a hard time performing well in high school due to factors out of your control, look for scholarships and grants specifically for people coming from similar circumstances. Living expenses are those expenses you would have whether or not you were in school. This includes rent, food, transportation, and even fun stuff. Practice good financial literacy on your living expenses. Basically, this means don't spend money you don't have. Be critical of your living expenses. You don't have to have your own apartment, or eat out every day, or have the latest phone. In many cases, you don't even have to own a car. A single college student can actually live a good quality of life without spending too much. My first couple years of college, I was able to save some money by living at home. You may be thinking, well duh, living at home is really cheap, but that's not an option for most people. Agreed. However, most of the time I was living at home, I was also on the swim team. On a week without a meet, that's the equivalent of a 20-hour job, without getting paid. Once I finished with swimming, I began looking for meaningful sources of income, even though I was late to the party. Some people are afraid that getting a job in college will take too much time away from school. But let me pose this question. Why are you even in college? I hope it's to prepare you for a better job. Well, I hate to break it to you, but you also need work experience to find a good job after graduation. Are you studying to be an engineer? Students in engineering can actually start making decent money before they graduate. Look for internships or research positions in your field. If you're taking the summer off of classes, do everything you can to get a well-paying internship or job. If your education isn't doing a good job of training you to make money along the way, that's usually a bad sign. The key to financial success tomorrow is wisely investing in today. There are many kinds of investments. For example, you can invest in the stock market, where you can expect that putting down money now will get you more later. While in school, your education is your investment, an investment in yourself. Treat college as you would an investment. Do your research. Figure out the best way you can invest your time and money in your education and training so that it pays back for you. Too many people these days go to college simply because someone else told them to, but they end up with a big stack of debt and a skill set that won't help them pay it off. Remember, the payout of this investment depends on you. Another good tip is to not waste time. These are the best years of your life. I didn't get an internship offer my first two summers, so I decided to take classes and continue working part-time, and it allowed me to graduate a year early. So there you have it. What do you do to make it through college? Leave a comment below, and if you learned something, be sure to like, subscribe, and share with your poor college friends.